Do we have a bone here still? Okay, for you, fine. Sternal notch is the upper margin of the sternum. Make your neck like this. Go down, go down, go down. You will find a ridge like this. Your finger will cross through a ridge. This is sternal angle. Angle between the manubrium and the body. Okay? The manubrium is like this, going back, bending backward, and here it is going in front. So this is the angle of, then the second angle of Lewis or sternal angle. The sternal angle has many importances. Number one, three clinical importances. If I find the sternal angle here, so here is the right side, here is the sternal notch, here is the sternal angle, and after this, if I follow this sternal angle on lateral side, I am falling in the second intercostal space, for sure, for everyone. Then I have to count the third intercostal, fourth, fifth, sixth, like this. This I have to count the spaces, the intercostal. This is one importance. Another importance is, think an imaginary line going down vertically, and it will meet the fourth level of fourth, lower margin of fourth thoracic vertebra, and this is going to divide the whole of the pericardium, whole of the mediastinum into superior mediastinum and inferior mediastinum. Another importance. The third importance is the vertebral layer is going from lower part of the base of the skull to the fourth vertebra. So fourth vertebra is very famous for these three reasons. So here is the sternum. Okay, this is the Zeffy sternum, Zeffoid process. Here is the abdominal cavity. We are not concerned. Here is the diaphragm. This is the diaphragm, dome of the diaphragm. Right dome of diaphragm, left dome of diaphragm, domes of diaphragm. And you can clearly see phrenic nerve going to the diaphragm. Okay, mm-hmm. Phrenic nerve here, going to the diaphragm. I said the anterior mediastinum is a very thin space, only this, or only if I rupture the pericardium, only I could reach. Very thin space. Why? Because in front is the sternum, here is the pericardium with all its contents, and here are the merging anterior border of the lungs. So this very small place, a few lymphatics, a few, two important structures are above and below. Probably I am hitting this superior pericardial ligament if I touch this margin. This is, I am hitting superior sternopericardial ligament. There is another sternopericardial ligament on the lower end. Okay? Then, all this is pericardium with all its contents. In this model, yes, you can very clearly see intercostal nerves and vessels. Okay? This is descending thoracic aorta, abdominal aorta with its branches. And here is the branches from vagus nerve and other. This model is specifically showing you this diaphragm, opening in the diaphragm. Then here is, try to go layer by layer, not to confuse yourself. Thyroid cartilage, larynx, trachea. See the rings of trachea, you can see. Follow the trachea, you will find two bronchi. Here one bronchus, another bronchus. With their subsequent divisions, no problem. But two main bronchus. This part is called carina. Okay? Then, here is arch of aorta. You can very clearly find. Arch of aorta has three branches here, going towards carotid. So subclavian and brachiocephalic and internal carotid, these are carotid, common carotids. Okay, this is arch of aorta. Then you can find vessels making you superior vena cava. So here is the superior vena cava. So jugular and subclavian, they join and they make this brachiocephalic vein, jugular and subclavian, and both of them, they when they join, they make superior vena cava. This is. This is probably the phrenic nerve going towards the diaphragm, and these are the intercostal blood vessels and nerves VAN is the tartib. The uppermost is the vein, artery, and then the nerve, intercostal. And these are the intercostal muscles. And you can feel the ribs and the intercostal spaces. Inferiorly, here is the aortic opening of the diaphragm, and from here it is the aorta is becoming thoracic or abdominal, descending abdominal aorta. On the back, there's again ribs and intercostal muscles with central muscles of the back and nothing more special. Any mushkil?
How will the questions be for this example?
Good. The question can become like, actually, here, if I label this model, name this part of mediastinum, for example. Yeah. So this, then he can ask the boundaries of posterior. Or in simple questions like SEQs or somewhere, list the boundaries of fulla and content of fulla, like this, maybe. Or you can have identification of the parts of, or the visceral parts, like this, like this, like this, or diaphragm, which body, which mediastinal surface or the model it is making, like this question, related question to the contents. Any question?